It's important with your Flash projects to embed your fonts. And this is true whether you're using a custom font like I am here, which is called Blade Runner Movie Font that I got from defont.com, or you're using something that's common across all systems such as Arial or Times New Roman, you still need to embed the font to prevent errors from happening. So let's go ahead and see what one of these errors looks like. This is my solar system game, and I'm going to preview the video now. And first of all, you can see that I have the font is showing up, which is good, but I'm getting some output errors that says it needs to be embedded. And I'm not seeing any effects of that right here, but that's okay. Let's move on. And this is where the user is going to enter their name. And I'm going to type a capital letter and then some lowercase. And that worked out well for me. But sometimes people won't be able to type capital letters, or they'll try to type like an exclamation point and that's not going to work for them. Or it'll randomly skip some lowercase letters for no reason. So that's a problem that has to do with embedding your font. Right now it looks like it's okay for me, but as soon as I click start game, it's weird because I'm just getting OOLESS. And I have it set up in ActionScript to say good luck, Jessica. So let's go ahead and embed this font. Now I can go ahead and get inside this symbol so that when I come to properties, it's showing that Blade Runner movie font, and it doesn't really matter what size it is or what color it is. But now I can click embed and I can call this Blade Runner. And it's going to save the family, and if it had a style, you would choose which style it's going to save. So make sure you're choosing the correct one. So for this, I know that I'm only going to have people doing, let's say, uppercase, lowercase, numerals, and punctuation. And I'm not really going to worry about basic Latin and Korean and all that other kind of stuff. If you're unsure, you can always do all. And we'll just do that for now, just in case. So that's all you have to do is just name it, make sure you have the right family and style, and then just choose what type of characters you think people are going to type. So I'll click OK. And if I look in my library panel, now you can see a little A icon showing you that this is an embedded font. And we named it Blade Runner because if we just had font 1, font 2, font 3, we wouldn't know which one we hadn't embedded. Because even though I test the movie right now, I'm going to get another font embedded error. And that's because I have fonts in my buttons. I have fonts later on in the instruction area. Oops, let's get out of there. I have all this font right here, whatever font this is. So I'm going to click on this font here, and this is Franklin Gothic Medium Regular. So I'll click Embed. I'm going to call this Franklin, Gothic Medium Regular. And I can choose all for that. And if this had been, let's say, italic, I would need to come in and embed that as well. Let me undo that. And then I can click here. And unfortunately, this is different. This is Futura, so I'll have to embed that, but I'm going to go ahead and make it Franklin Gothic because that's just a lot of embedded font. They don't really differ that much that between Futura and Franklin. So again, if I did italic here, I'd have to embed it, and I need to check in my buttons and see what font that is, and that's Franklin Gothic Medium. So I think I should be okay. Let me test it. And now I'm not getting that error. And when I go in and enter my name, even if I do a space and my last name, I should be able to see good luck, Jessica Eddington. Uh-oh. And this is not a problem with the font. It's just that my text box isn't long enough for somebody's name that's that long. But it is working. It is showing all the letters when before it wasn't, and it was throwing out errors. So you need to make sure that you're embedding your font so there's not errors and people can successfully use your application or your movie or your game without wondering, is it broken? Is it their fault? Is it still loading? So make sure you're embedding your font.